All right, what up everybody? It's your boy Akeen here to talk about the Russell Athletic Bowl between 8-4 OU Oklahoma against 9-3 Clemson. Now, I'm gonna start things off with Clemson. They're seeking to have their fourth straight 10-win season. They're having another good year. DeMar on the defensive side, allowing just 17.6 points per game, and that is actually sixth in the country. And they're led by an All-American and ACC Defensive Player of the Year winner, Vic Beasley, with 28 tackles this season to go along with 11 sacks, a great pass rusher, and one of my top 15 prospects for the 2015 NFL Draft. Now, for OU, they had a little bit of a down year, in my personal opinion. They actually started off their season in the preseason top five because of their huge performance, especially from quarterback Trevor Knight in the Sugar Bowl against a great Alabama Crimson Tide team, and they ended up a little bit of a disappointment with all their four of their losses came in conference play. This was a terrible season for Trevor Knight. In my opinion, I thought he was going to live to the potential of what he did in the Sugar Bowl. 14 touchdown passes and 9 interceptions this season to go along with just under 2,200 yards passing. He struggled a lot this season throwing the football. But there was a lot of hope in their ground attack with freshman running back Samaz Perrine, who had 1,579 yards rushing and 21 scores, a record for most rushing touchdowns as a freshman. And he even has the NCAA single game rushing record in the game against Kansas with 427 yards rushing and 5 scores, breaking Melvin Gordon's record, which was just a week prior to the Kansas game for Perrine. Now, for the players that I believe that you need to watch for this matchup, I mentioned the players for OU, but there are also a couple of other players on the defensive side for the Sooners that I do like, and that is their linebackers and sophomore Dominic Alexander and junior Eric Stryker. Now, let's first talk about Alexander. He definitely has a good nose for the football, 99 tackles this season. Now, for Eric Stryker, he's the pass rushing linebacker between the two at 6 foot, 221 pounds. He had 56 tackles this season to go along with 7.5 sacks. He could be a prospect for the 2015 NFL draft, but I believe that he should stay for one more year as a senior, get more experience, and boost up his draft status. Now, for Clemson, I do like Vic Beasley a lot. He is definitely the player that you need to watch in this matchup. Now, the key for this game is going to be rely on quarterback Cole Stott for Clemson, because in the last two games against Power 5 opponents, Stott actually passed for 4 interceptions and 0 touchdowns. He's going to have to step it up. Now, for this season, Clemson has been doing a lot of flip-flop at quarterback between Cole Stott and freshman Deshaun Watson. I firmly believe that Watson is the better quarterback between the two, but he's going to have surgery on an already injured knee, which means Stout is going to get the starting position for this particular matchup, and he is a senior this season. But if Stout has a good game throwing the football, I believe that Clemson has a great chance. He needs to put the ball in the hands of their playmakers and their freshman running back, Wayne Goldman, who leads the team in rushing, and he's been doing a great job in the second half of the season running the football effectively. And sophomore wide receiver Mike Williams, who leads the team in receiving. Stout needs to do a good job throwing the football, no turnovers, and be smart and be calm within the pocket. I believe that Clemson's defense is going to do a great job in this matchup. Same for OU, but I have to go with Clemson in this one because their defense is just better than OU. OU actually allows over 20 points per game compared to 17.6 for Clemson. So I'm going to have to go with the Tigers over the Sooners in this matchup, but this should be a great bowl matchup for the Russell Athletic Bowl. Now, I have one more blog I'm going to talk about for today, and that is actually the Texas Bowl between my Longhorns and the Arkansas Razorbacks. I'll see you guys in just a couple of minutes. Thank you for watching this blog. I'm your man, Akeem McCall, BEC.